warm welcome. You're watching the news with me, Anubhuti Gaur. Let's take a look at what's making headlines. Congress Chief Sonia Gandhi led an opposition delegation that met President Ramnath Kovind regarding the center's new citizenship bill and the widespread protest in its aftermath. The opposition had demanded a judicial inquiry into the police action. Congress had claimed that the Delhi police was working under the orders of the BJP, pointing out that in Union Territories, the force was under the center's control. The Citizenship Act protest turned violent in Delhi's Seelampur area as protesters threw stones at policemen who fired at the crowd and used tear gas shells. A school bus was damaged and a police picket was set on fire. The police lathi charged the crowds and fired tear gas shells as protesters threw stones at buses and the policemen. At least two policemen were injured. The entry and exit gates at seven metro stations has been shut. Home Minister Amit Shah hits south at the opposition on the amended citizenship law, says opposition is misleading people. I reiterate that there is no question of taking away citizenship of any person from any minority community. There is no such provision in the bill. Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray compared the police action in Jamia Millia Islamia University and its neighbouring areas with the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. He said what happened at Jamia is like Jallianwala Bagh. Students are like a Yuva bomb. So we request the central government to not do what they have been doing with the students. Delhi police releases video showing joint CP appealing protesters for peace at the Jamia Millia Islamia University to stay calm and to stop stone pelting. The joint CP can be heard telling the students to come out and hold dialogue and stop the violence, else they will have to use force. Delhi police and students of Jamia University clashed on December 15. The Supreme Court refuses to entertain petitions on Jamia and AMU protests, asks petitioners to approach High Court's concern, says it is not feasible to appoint a single committee to go into the matters of different states. The CJI spells out two basic concerns: one, students being arrested without knowledge of VCs, and second, about medical aid to students who were injured during the clashes. 10 people, many of whom have criminal backgrounds, have been arrested in connection with the Sunday's violent clashes involving Jamia Millia Islamia students and the Delhi police. Although no students have been arrested so far, sources claim the cops have yet not given a clean chit to the students. Those arrested are from the Jamia and Okhla areas, both of which border the university. The Australian government on Tuesday asked its citizens to exercise high degree of caution while travelling to India, which has witnessed violent protests against the amended Citizenship Act. Last week, the US, UK, Singapore, Canada and Israel had warned their citizens against travelling to Northeast India in view of the violent protest against the Citizenship Amendment Act. In the first in Pakistan's history, former Pakistan President Parvez Musharraf has been sentenced to death by a court in a high treason case, according to the Pakistani media reports. The treason case against Parvez Musharraf was initiated by former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif for imposing a state of emergency in the country on November 2007. The case was pending since 2013. Parvez Musharraf left for Dubai in 2016 to seek medical treatment and has not returned since. In March, he was admitted to a hospital in Dubai after suffering from an ailment. That's all in this bulletin. Thanks for watching. The news and updates will continue on the other side.